Today has been, as I was reminded, entering into the church, a day of great rejoicing and also a day that has been awaited for several years. And it is appropriate that we celebrate the dedication of this new church of Holy Name on the feast of the exaltation of the cross of Jesus Christ. For it is his cross that gives meaning to our lives and to the life of every human person. It is Jesus and Jesus alone who is the only Savior of the world. And only if we truly encounter him and enter into relationship with him will we receive the gift of the forgiveness of our sins and eternal life. It is appropriate to celebrate this dedication because if you listen attentively to the prayers of dedication, they focus on worshiping the true God and on the one sacrifice of Christ. And it is precisely the one sacrifice of Christ that will be made present on this altar. It is the one sacrifice of Christ that we join in offering ourselves in every Eucharist, with, in, and through Jesus to the Father. In the first reading from the book of the prophet Nehemiah, he speaks of the Jewish people gathering as one man and giving praise and adoration and worship to God. It is in Jesus Christ that that is most fulfilled, because Jesus leads us to the Father. Jesus, his deepest desire is that we come to know the love of the Father for us, and his desire to be with us. And we truly do gather as one man in Jesus Christ, because each of us has been baptized and confirmed in Christ. And as we live the Eucharist and receive the Eucharist throughout our lives, as it nourishes us, we are in Christ and offering ourselves to the Father. And so it is in the one man Christ, in he who is true God and true man, that we receive and worship the Father in spirit and in truth. In the Gospel reading, as Jesus is speaking to Nicodemus, he reminds him of the imagery of the serpent, of the bronze serpent that Moses raised in the desert. And as the people gazed upon it, they were healed and did not die. And the same is true, he says, for the Son of Man, who will be lifted up, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. And then as St. John reflects upon that truth, he reminds us, God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. We must always remember, as St. John reminds us, God did not send Jesus into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. And that is why we are filled with urgency today, to be those who go out into the world, inviting people to be in relationship with Jesus Christ, to come to know the love of the Eternal Father that every human being has been made for. And the Eucharist is what nourishes us and sends us on mission into the world, into the peripheries that Pope Francis speaks of, constantly proposing and never imposing, as St. John Paul, the great, would remind us, offering people that relationship. And just as our parents, our grandparents, our ancestors passed on that relationship to us and invited us into that relationship, so too are we called to do the same today. And my beloved brothers and sisters, in 10, 20, 30, 40 years from now, 100 years from now, many of us will be dead and gone. But there will still be people who come to this very church and worship in spirit and truth. We must never forget that if we enter into eternal life, the Lord is faithful to his promise, and every generation is invited into that life. In the second reading from Paul's letter to the Philippians, he sings a great hymn to Jesus Christ and the uniqueness of Christ. He recognizes that Jesus is true God and true man. But Jesus, unlike Adam and Eve, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. But rather, Jesus, in his humanity, empties himself, takes the form of a slave. He humbles himself, becoming obedient to death, death on a cross. And there are many things to reflect upon that great truth. First is that Jesus, in his humanity, unlike human beings, did not grasp at God and say, I want to be God. But rather, he humbled himself and became obedient. And he became obedient to eternal love. When we look upon that crucifix, it is the very revelation of love. It is not suffering for the sake of suffering. It is not embracing suffering because I want to suffer. But rather, it is choosing love. It is loving that is chosen. The love of humanity. The love of the other. And all of you, or at least many of you, have experienced suffering love, in which you choose to suffer for the sake of the other. Maybe as parents, you had to spend the night with your children as they were sick. Or maybe as a child or young adult, you had to stand guard at your parents' bed as they were dying. And you do it for love. And there is suffering there. The suffering does not overpower the love. But rather, the love is strengthened in the midst of the sacrifice that is made. And Jesus reminds us, if we are true disciples of his, that we will deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow in his steps. And that is exactly what he did. He denied himself in his humanity, took up his cross for us. He died for each one of us, so that our sins, my sins, may be forgiven, that I may come to know the love of the Father. And that is the reason why we as Christians still celebrate the cross and the exaltation of the cross. The Jewish people and the Romans thought for sure, we are done with this guy, it's over. They put him to death by the most heinous means of capital punishment. They crucified him to the cross. All of us know the shock and the horror that is present in our hearts as we see and watch the video of men being beheaded in our own time. That's over in an instant. Crucifixion was not over in an instant. And he did that all for love. And in the midst of that, we see why his name is exalted. The Jewish people did not believe his promise that in 3 days I would rise. Not even his disciples, even when they found the empty tomb, did they believe. They searched for his body. Where have you hidden him? But he was risen. Sin and death were conquered for those who put their faith in him, for those who believe. And no matter how the world has tried to trample out Christianity in different generations, they have never succeeded because of the truth and the love of the message. And our times are no different. We too are the ones who, no matter what the suffering we may experience, are called to proclaim and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. And we will be willing to suffer anything for that truth. As we continue with our celebration of the Eucharist this afternoon, and as we enter into the actual dedication rites, I encourage you, be attentive to the prayers that I will pray as I dedicate the altar, as I anoint the walls. Listen to those prayers with your hearts, for they speak of Christ, giving true worship to the Father. Also, let us pray. Let us pray for the virtues of humility and obedience, that like Christ, we may grow in those virtues. We first have to desire them. And it's not a false humility, but it's the true humility of recognizing everything as a gift. It is the true humility of recognizing that I do not merit or earn anything, but it is the outpouring of the Father's love that I am called into and to live in Jesus Christ. And pray to Jesus. Open your hearts to Jesus and ask him, Lord, grant to me the same humility as your humility. Lord, grant to me the same obedience as your obedience. When you pray the words of the Our Father, thy will be done. Need those words. Seeking the will. finally, as we receive the Eucharist today, let us lift up our hearts in gratitude. For there is much to give gratitude to God and to the Father for, even in the times in which we live. The Eucharist means thanksgiving. And so speak within your own heart, heart to heart with Jesus. Open your hearts to Him, thanking Him for the gift of eternal life, for the gift of faith, for the gift of this house of worship, for the gift of His cross. And may we meditate upon the words that Jesus spoke to us in today's gospel. So must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in Him